end that in the last 2 years, over 3,000 people have been murdered in the Southern Cameroon. Over the last two years, over 3,000 people have been slaughtered in Southern Cameroon. And it is our duty in the Southern Cameroon.
Do my life underestimate? I see life underestimate.
And it is our duty.
I see life underestimate.
Stand up for them.
Emmanuel.
In the last 2 years, over 30 people.
No, no, so give them room. No, tell the pastor message be important.
In the past 2 years.
See, no, something. That's what they talk. See, no. See, book details. See, Emma.
Major the talk. Think it going to disturb them more. Come on.
In the past 2 years.
No, we'll get after. If we get them, nothing around one now.
We have over 35 people that have been burnt alive in their houses. We have over 182 villages that have been burnt.
This is our community. This is our flag.
All this has been happening. When President Samuel and her government use lobbyists to block the mainstream media from bringing it to the public, we are calling on every moral citizen of the world to be the voice of those women. We are calling on every modern citizen of the world to be the voice of the over 4,000 people that are in jail in the Southern Cameroon. We are calling on all modern citizens of the world to be the voice of the over 150 internally displaced persons because of the war in the past 2 years. We are calling on the modern citizens of the world to be the voice of the close to 500 unaccompanied minors in Nigeria as a result of this crisis. We are calling on citizens of the world to be the voice of the over 45,000 refugees in the last 2 years displaced in Nigeria, as estimated by the United Nations. We want to thank you here for coming to in solidarity with our people. One thing we ask you is to ask your local MP, who is helping to cover the atrocities of May and her government? Why is the British government training Cameroon soldiers who go around killing innocent citizens in the Southern Cameroon? We are calling on the British government to withdraw the aid that is given to Cameroon. It is unacceptable that a woman of 85 years is burnt alive by a military that is sponsored by Her Majesty's government. We call this gross injustice, and we are going to stay on this road now until that justice is done. What do we want?
Justice!
What do we want?
Justice!
What do we want?
Justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
When do we want it?
Now!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Justice!
What do we want?
Justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
Fellow citizens of the world, the Southern Cameroon's children are your children. We have 10 pro-democracy leaders who stood up against this barbaric regime sponsored by Theresa May and Patricia Scotland. They are all lecturers. They are all lecturers in universities. They sat in Nigeria discussing the refugee crisis. They were all abducted by the government of Nigeria and illegally deported to Cameroon. Today, a death sentence tagged over their head because May, aiding the Cameroon government, has tagged them as terrorists. We are calling on you to be their voice, because if you do not be their voice, May will help Pobia to execute these pro-democracy leaders, and we do not want that. We are counting on you to go out there and be the voice of the women whose husbands are in jail. Ladies and gentlemen, standing up for the people who are marginalized The people who are suffering is a moral duty of every citizen of the world. And what you have done today is the right thing to do. We call on you to continuously do so. We must stick together. We must keep fighting. Because this injustice has continued to become law. Therefore, resistance is our
duty.
Resistance is our
duty.
So, ladies and gentlemen, wherever you go, keep the resistance on Twitter. We call on you to tweet using the hashtag Justice for Naira 10. Hashtag Justice for Naira 10. Hashtag Free Southern Cameroon. We thank you so much. Keep up. Let us not give up. Don't give up.
Oh, yeah.